Welcome to Science Store online classes.
Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.
Hello students. We were dealing with chapter some basic concepts of chemistry. We have already studied about significant figures and we have studied about mathematical operations of scientific notations. And we also know how to round off the values and limit the significant figures. Today, let us take some problems related to rounding off and limiting the significant figures. Let's have a addition problem. Let's take the numbers this way: 12.11, 18.0, and 1.012. Let's add these numbers. When we add these numbers, the values what we get is 2, 1 plus 1, 2, 1, 0, 0, when added 1, 0.18 plus 1 is 19, 19 plus 12 is 31. So the answer we have got is 31.122. This is the answer we have got. Now, during addition as well as subtraction, during addition and subtraction, answer or result cannot have more significant figures or more digits to the right of decimal point. Than either of original numbers. This is the rule to have the significant figures. See what the rule says: you do addition or subtraction, result cannot have more digits to the right of decimal point than either of original numbers. What does it mean? Look at the first number taken here to do the addition. It is 12.11. So here 12.11 has two significant figures. It has two significant figures after decimal point. Look at the next number. What we have is 18.0. In 18.0, there is only one significant figure after decimal point. Look at another number, 1.012. Here, there are totally three significant figures after decimal point. Because you know, the zeros which come after non-zero digit, they are significant. So totally we have three significant figures after a decimal point. Now what the rule says is, you can have the digits which are equal to any one of the added numbers and where after decimal point there are least numbers. Look at here, 12.11 after decimal point two significant figures are there. 18.0, there is only one significant figure. In 1.012, there are three significant figures. So answer which you report must have only one significant figure after decimal point, because out of the three added numbers, 18.0 has least number of significant figures after decimal point. So answer must have one significant figure, only one significant figure after decimal point. After decimal point. Therefore, what we can do? We have to round off now. Answer actually we have got is 31.122. Rule says you must have least significant figures as that of the added numbers after a decimal point. That means we can have only one significant figure after a decimal point. So answer 31.122 must be rounded off. It must be rounded off. So how many digits? After decimal point you have to have only one digit. That means you must remove the last digit too. If I remove the last digit too, previous digit is kept as it is, because last digit which I remove is less than 5. So it becomes 31.12. Now according to the rule, I can have only one significant figure after decimal point. So I must remove this last digit too. The last digit to be removed is less than 5. So previous digit is kept as it is. So answer is 31.1. So reported answer is 31.1. Understand students, whenever you do addition or subtraction, you will get some answer. Answer must have least significant figures after decimal point as that of the original numbers. Now here the three numbers I've taken in which 18.0 has one significant figure after decimal point. So reported answer must have only one significant figure. To do that, you have to round off the answer as per the rounding off rules. So these are the rules followed for the addition and subtraction. Now what are the rules followed for the multiplication and division? I will take a problem related to multiplication. Let's take multiplication. Whatever rules we apply for the multiplication, same rules are followed for the division also. Let's take the numbers this way. 2.5 into 1.325. Or let's have a smaller number. I'll take 1.25. 2.5 into 1.25. When you multiply this, answer you'll get as 3.125. This is the answer we will get. But remember students, this answer you cannot report as such. You have to round off. What are the rounding off rules here? In multiplication and division, answer must have least significant figures. Answer must have least significant figures or least digits least significant figures as that of original numbers as that of original numbers. Whatever rules I explained for the multiplication, same rules have to be followed when you do the division also. Remember, when you do multiplication or a division, answer reported must have least significant figures as that of the original numbers multiplied or divided. Now look at here. The numbers multiplied are 2.5 and 1.25. 2.5 has totally two significant figures. Here you have to count total significant figures, not the significant figures after decimal point. Totally I have two significant figures here, 2 and 5. Whereas 1.25, here there are totally three significant figures, 1, 2 and 5. So answer must have two significant figures only. Why? Because among the two numbers multiplied, 2.5 has least significant figures. Only so many significant figures you have to have in the answer. Here 2.5 has two significant figures, 1.25 has three significant figures. Our answer must have only two significant figures because 2.5 has two significant figures only. But the answer which we have got totally has four significant figures. 3.125 means 3, 1, 2, 5. Totally we have four significant figures, which we have to limit to two significant figures. To do that, we have to round off. So let's round off. Hence, 3.125 is rounded off. It must be rounded off. Rounded off to how many significant figures? Rounded off to two significant figures. Means here last digit have to be removed. The last digit to be removed is equal to 5. Previous digit is even a number. You know, when last digit to be removed is equal to 5, previous digit when it is even number, previous digit is kept as it is. So it becomes 3.12. Now how many significant figures are there? Count. Three significant figures are there. But how many I want? I want only two significant figures. Means again I have to remove last digit. Look at the last digit to be removed. It is 2. It is less than 5. So previous digit is kept as it is. So it is rounded off to 3.1. This 3.1 is the reported answer. It is a reported answer. So always remember, whenever you do addition or subtraction, the significant figures should be least after decimal point as that of any original number added or subtracted. There after decimal point you have to count the least significant figures. But in case of multiplication and division, total significant figures must be least as that of any original number multiplied or divided. So these you have to keep in mind. These concepts are important for the NEET GE point of view. Hope it is clear to you. Next we'll move on to another concept, that is a dimensional analysis. Let's take up dimensional analysis. Dimensional analysis is also called as unit factor method. It is also called as unit factor method, or it is also called as factor label method. factor label method. What is unit factor method or factor label method? Why this is needed? This is required to convert units of measurements. It is required to convert units of measurements. This method you know already, you are using it already, but name is new to you. What is it actually? Say for example, you measure the length in meters. Udda, length in meters. You will convert into centimeters. You can even convert into millimeters. See these conversions, meter into centimeter, centimeter into meter, that is nothing but dimensional analysis. Even another example, if I give mass of a substance, we measure in kilograms, kg. Kilograms can be converted into grams. Grams can be converted into milligrams. Milligrams can be converted into grams. Grams can be converted into kilogram. These conversions of units is a dimensional analysis. Let's take example for this. You will understand problems related to dimensional analysis. Let's take one problem. Convert 3 inches into centimeter. Problem is convert 3 inches into centimeter. You will be given conversion factor, that is relation between inch and centimeter f. You will be given, it is given that 1 inch is equal to 2.54 centimeter. This will be given. 1 inch is equal to 2.54 centimeter. From this conversion factor, you have to derive unit factor. You have to derive unit factor. What is unit factor? Look at here. 1 inch divided by 2.54 centimeter is equal to 1. Get this term to the other side. So it becomes 1 inch divided by 2.54. On the right side of equal to mark, the unit is 1. So 1 inch divided by 2.54 centimeter is equal to 1. Or the same you can write this way. You can get 1 inch to the other side. So it becomes 2.54 centimeter divided by 1 inch. That is also equal to 1. So 1 equal to 2.54 centimeter divided by 1 inch. Look at here, 1 inch divided by 2.54 centimeter is equal to 1 is one unit factor. One more unit factor you have is 2.54 centimeter divided by 1 inch. That is also equal to 1. Now, whenever you do dimensional analysis, you have to select suitable unit factor. Now, what is the problem I have? 3 inch. I have to convert it into centimeter. Means I have to cancel 3 inch. Inch unit must be cancelled. And I have to obtain the new unit, centimeter. So, thinking those things, keeping in mind these things, you have to select the suitable unit factor. So let us convert. I have 3 inch. I want to convert into centimeter. So I'll write 3 inch as it is. I want to cancel unit inch. And I want to get the new unit centimeter. If I want to cancel inch, inch should come in the denominator. If I want to get the centimeter as the unit, it must come in the numerator. So, among these two unit factors, better if I choose this one. So, I'll choose this one, 2.54 centimeter divided by 1 inch. First write the unit factors, then based on the calculation select the appropriate or suitable unit factor. Now 3 inch is equal to 2.54 centimeter divided by 1 inch. Now here if you see, inch cancel. Now what remains? 3 into 2.54 centimeter. Multiply these, 3 into 2.54. When you multiply this, multiply 3 4s are 12, 1 remaining, 3 5s are 15, and 1 6, 16 it is, 1 remaining, 3 2s are 6, 1 remaining when added 7. Here decimal point, after decimal point you have 2 digits. So in the answer also after decimal point you have to have 2 digits. So answer is 7.62. What is the unit remaining? Inch got cancelled. Unit remaining is centimeter. So finally we have converted inches into centimeter and we have got the answer as 3 inch is equal to 7.62 centimeter. So this is one problem related to dimensional analysis. So if you look at the problem, you'll clearly understand that it is the conversion of one unit into another unit for the same quantity. So conversions of units is done using dimensional analysis. Let's have another problem. Let's take up one more problem related to dimensional analysis. Question is, how many seconds are there in 2 days? How many seconds are there in 2 days? This is the problem I have. Days are given, should convert into seconds. Days must be converted into seconds. How it can be done? First you have to convert day to hours. Hours are converted into minutes. Then minutes are converted into seconds. You all know, one day is equal to 24 hours. So we can write different unit factors. We know one day is equal to 24 hours. That means one day divided by 24 hours is equal to 1. See, this is because one day is equal to 24 hours. One day is equal to 24 hours. Hence, one day divided by 24 hours is equal to 1. Or 24 hours divided by one day is also equal to 1. Now let's convert hours into minutes. We know 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. It is equal to 60 minutes. So one more unit factor is 1 hour divided by 60 minutes is equal to 1. 1 hour divided by 60 minutes is equal to 1. Or 60 minutes divided by 1 hour is also equal to 1. 60 minutes divided by 1 hour is also equal to 1. Minutes can be converted into seconds. We know 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. So we can write one more unit factor. That is 1 minute divided by 60 seconds is equal to 1. Or 60 seconds divided by 1 minute is also equal to 1. So these are the different unit factors we have. Now let's do the conversions. I have 2 days which I have to convert into seconds. First convert days into hours, then into minutes, then into seconds. So 2 days is equal to, I'll write 2 days as it is. Now I want to cancel the unit day. So day must come in the denominator. So which has to be chosen? This one, 24 hour divided by 1 day. So suitable unit factor chosen is 24 hours divided by 1 day. So here what happens? Unit day and day cancels. Now there is unit hours. I want to cancel unit hours. So hour must come in the denominator. So suitable unit factor is this one, 60 minute divided by 1 hour. So I'll choose this, multiplied by 60 minute divided by 1 hour. Here what happens? Hour cancels out. Unit remaining is minute. We want to cancel minute also because we have to get the unit finally second. So which is suitable? This one, 60 second divided by 1 minute. So into 60 second divided by 1 minute. So it is minute cancels out. What remains? 2 into 24 into 60 into 60, unit is a second. Multiply these values. What you get is, answer you'll get it as 172,800 seconds. So finally, we have converted 2 days into seconds. 2 days is equal to 172,800 seconds. So this is how we can convert units of measurements into higher units or lower units. Here we have converted days into seconds. In the previous problem, we had converted inches into centimeter. So like this, you can take any units, and if you have conversion factors or unit factors, you can convert it into any unit. This is useful whenever we do calculations. So this is all about dimensional analysis or a unit factor method or factor label method. Thank you.
Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.